Okay, good morning students. This entire section I will put in YouTube after completion. So first lesson, and you need to perform and you take screenshots, and you need to upload your observation as well as the screenshots, okay, as per our requirement. So today we are going to start our lab. That is nothing but in this lab, in this session I will explain three different things. So I will show how to do. So apart from that, you need to try different options in that scrolling into in per suppose if you take LCD. So I will show an example in that. So you try for a different way. That is nothing but how to move from left to right, right to left, how to scroll it, how to stop the scrolling. So such type of things you do. So same way, stepper motor. If I show stepper motor, so if I show in clockwise direction, how to do in anti-clockwise direction, like that you need to do. So far we discussed it. Last week I given certain exercise also for you. So maybe some people already performed and they uploaded in WhatsApp or in Moodle also some people are did. So after completion of their thing, their exercise only, they pasted. That is nothing but they submitted their observation. So I hope maximum people are completed their exercise. That is nothing but first experiment. The experiment number one. So you write aim. Aim of our experiment is interface. Aim to interface eight LEDs and switches. LPC 2148. That is our aim. So first we will prepare our software, then after that we will do that thing. So before going to that thing, we need to take certain thing called project. So already you know these steps. If you have any doubt, once again you can ask. So I will go to my Keel. Okay, go to new project, MacroVision new project. So here I am taking one example. That is nothing but LED and switch. Okay, LED and switch 8. So simply because I want to recognize this thing, that's why I am putting LED and switch 8. So like that I am taking. So save, and after that I need to select NX. That is nothing but a Philips foundation I need to take. Okay, so after that, so I need to select LPC 2148. Okay, this is the LPC 2148. So once it is done, just to all add files to this project and everything, that is must and should required. So previously you have some file in that. So last week we did some program. So same thing I will take. What is that file? Open. LCD and LED and switch we did. Yeah, S and LED, SW LED. Yeah. So this thing already we completed. Last week we did this thing. So in your observation also this code is there. So now here by this code only you need to do the entire program. So that's why I am copying this code first. So because I don't want this thing right now, so I am closing that thing. A new text file I am taking. So in that same code previously what we written, hash include std.h. So this is to okay involve all registers of ARM7. Okay, so ARM7 processor, all registers if you want to install, so involve the into your program, you need to include this thing. That is a linker duty. So next to define S1. So here we define something called S1. So according to our plan, we need to plan first. So which pins I want to select for input, which pins I want to select for output. So here I want to change my plan. But suppose previously we discussed like that, maybe if I want to change, I can. So here I go, direction I want to change. So which pins in the sense? So I am taking all 16 higher pins are outputs. So all 16 lower bits are, or lower pins are inputs. So like that I am taking. See, here I go direction of port 0, all higher pins, that is nothing but from 16 to 31 are output, from 0 to 15 are input. So here I am commenting like this. So from 16 to 31 pins are output. Okay, so from 16 to 31 pins are output, and so from 0 to 15 are input. Okay, like that I am selecting the direction, I go direction. And here I want to define S1. So S1 I will take, which pin you want to take, that is your choice. I will take 8 pin here. So no problem. If you take another pin also, no problem. So this one is required for me. So I will copy paste 8 times, because I want to 8 different switches. So switch 2, okay, switch 3, switch 4, okay, switch 5, and switch 6, and switch 7, switch 8. So total 8 switches I am connecting. So 1 to 8, so that is nothing but switch 2 is connected to 9th pin, switch 3 is connected to 10th pin, switch 4 is connected to 11th pin, switch 5 is connected to 12th pin, and switch 6 is connected to 13th pin, and 7 is connected to 14th pin, and last switch 8 is connected to 15th pin. So this is first what you want to do. Okay, I hope you understood. I want to confirm. So are you able to see? Yeah, are you able to see my program, what I am writing? Yeah, can anyone respond please? Yes or no? When I am typing all that code, yeah, is it visible to you? Okay, thank you. Because I want to confirm. Yeah. So here, these are nothing but the several switches, 8 switches I am taking. So all 8 switches are connected in this manner. Okay, so this is done. Now, int main void. So this IO direction already I changed like this. From 16 to 31 pins are output, and 0 to 15 pins are input. So here repetition mode I need to activate. So that is nothing but while 1. So in this while 1 only I want to write entire code. So already it is written for 1 pin. So here I am checking from 16th pin. So my 8th pin is related to 16th pin. That is nothing but what? Switch 1 is related to 16th pin LED. Okay. So what LED I connected on 16th pin. So for that I am connecting this. So IO clear R0 to 16th pin, else IO set R0 to 16th pin. So this is already previously we changed this thing. So that's why I want to change once again. Control X. Okay, this is the better way, because so this is the better way. Previously, now whenever you press the switch, only switch is on, then only LED is going to on. So that is the logic what you are writing. So switch 1, if you are talking about switch 1, so that switch 1 is related to 16th pin. When switch is on, automatically this one is going to on. So that is the actual thing we are discussing right now. So now the same code, so here I am taking from if to here. So it is related to one switch. Same way, that thing I want to copy and paste. How many times? 7 different times. Okay. Same thing required, because I have 8 switches right now. Okay, done. So copy paste is done. So now I am talking about switch 2. Okay, switch 2 is connected to 17th pin. What is the problem? Okay, simply I will change the pin numbers, that's it. Switch 3 is connected to 18th pin. Okay, switch 3 is connected to 18th pin. So done. Switch 4 is connected to 19th pin. Okay, done. Next, switch 5 is connected to లేబ్ క్లాస్లో ఉన్నాను సార్. ఓకే సార్ ఎస్ సార్ అదే చెప్పాను పిల్లలకి. మీరైతే ఒకసారి సార్కి ఇన్ఫామ్ చేయండి ఎవరెవరు వెళ్తున్నారో. ఎస్ సార్ శోభిత మేడం. ఎస్ సార్ ఎస్ సార్ ట్రైనింగ్కే పంపాలి సార్. ఓకే సార్ సార్ ఓకే సార్ ఓకే సార్ ఓకే సార్ ఓకే సార్ ఓకే సార్ క్లాస్లో ఉన్నాను సార్, నేను మాట్లాడతాను మళ్ళీ. ఓకే సార్ ఓకే. సో హియర్ దిస్ ఇస్ ద థింగ్, ఐ ఆల్రెడీ మోడిఫైడ్ ఆల్ ద పిన్స్. సో స్విచ్ 1 ఈజ్ కనెక్టెడ్ టు 16th పిన్, స్విచ్ 2 ఈజ్ కనెక్టెడ్ టు 17th అండ్ 18th, 19th లైక్ దట్. సో ఆల్ పిన్స్ అప్ టు స్విచ్ 8 ఈజ్ కనెక్టెడ్ టు 23rd పిన్. సో డన్. సో వన్స్ ఇట్ ఈస్ డన్, సో సింప్లీ యూ సేవ్ దట్ ఫైల్. సో ఐఎమ్ సేవింగ్ దిస్ ఫైల్ యాజ్ ఎల్ఈడి అండ్ SW8.C. సో సేమ్ యాజ్ లైక్ మై ప్రాజెక్ట్ నేమ్ LED SW8.C బికాస్ ఐ వాంట్ టు రికగ్నైజ్ లైక్ ఈజీలీ. సో ఫర్ దట్ సో హియర్ ఐఎమ్ గోయింగ్ టు దిస్ థింగ్ అండ్ యాడ్ ఫైల్స్ టు దిస్ గ్రూప్. సో ఎల్ఈడి SW.Switch. సో నౌ డన్. సో నౌ హియర్ ఓకే. సో వన్స్ కంపారిషన్ డన్, ఎనీ ఎర్రర్స్ అండ్ వార్నింగ్స్ ఆర్ దేర్ ఐ వాంట్ చెక్. సో దెర్ ఇస్ నో ఎర్రర్, దెర్ ఇస్ నో వార్నింగ్. సి హియర్ ఐ గాట్ 0 ఎర్రర్స్ అండ్ 0 వార్నింగ్స్. సో వన్స్ ఐ గాట్ 0 ఎర్రర్స్ అండ్ 0 వార్నింగ్స్, సింప్లీ జస్ట్ యు గో టు దిస్ థింగ్ అండ్ డీబగ్. ఓకే సో వన్స్ డీబగ్ సెషన్ స్టార్టెడ్, సో గో టు పెరిఫెరల్స్ అండ్ ఓపెన్ పోర్ట్ 0. సో దెన్ గో టు డీబగ్ అండ్ రన్. సో వన్స్ ఇట్ ఈస్ రన్నింగ్, సో నౌ దిస్ థింగ్స్ ఆర్ ఆల్రెడీ క్లియర్. అకార్డింగ్ టు దిస్ థింగ్ యూ నీడ్ టు చేంజ్. ఇఫ్ ఐ 8 ఈస్ సెలెక్టెడ్, సో దట్ ఆటోమేటిక్లీ సెలెక్టెడ్ 16. దట్ మీన్స్ వాట్? సో డిపెండ్స్ అపాన్ 8 ఆపరేషన్. సో ఐఎమ్ వర్కింగ్ విత్ 16th పిన్. సో డన్. సో ఎనీ ఫర్ సపోజ్ ఇఫ్ ఐఎమ్ వర్కింగ్ విత్ 10th పిన్, 11th పిన్, 8, 9, 10, 11. సో ఇఫ్ ఐఎమ్ వర్కింగ్ విత్ 11th పిన్, 11th పిన్ ఇస్ కనెక్టెడ్ టు సో 1, 2, 3, 4. సో దట్ నథింగ్ బట్ 20th పిన్. సో లైక్ దట్. సో కరస్పాండింగ్ పిన్స్ ఆర్ యాక్టివేటెడ్, నౌ ఇట్ ఈస్ వర్కింగ్. సో డిపెండ్స్ అపాన్ అవర్ ఇన్పుట్. సో అవుట్ ఈస్ కమింగ్. సో దట్ ఈస్ నథింగ్ బట్ ఇన్ సాఫ్ట్వేర్, సాఫ్ట్వేర్ కీ విల్ సాటిస్ఫై అవర్ అవుట్పుట్. సో నౌ డన్. సో నౌ జస్ట్ స్టాప్ ద డీబగ్గింగ్ సెషన్, దెన్ గో టు యువర్ కోడ్ అండ్ ఆప్షన్స్ పర్ టార్గెట్. సో యూ నీడ్ టు సెలెక్ట్ అవుట్పుట్, క్రియేట్ హెక్స్ ఫైల్ హియర్. సో దిస్ ఈస్ ద ఆప్షన్ యూ నీడ్ టు సెలెక్ట్ టు క్రియేట్ అన్ హెక్స్ ఫైల్ అండ్ గో టు లింకర్. సో యూస్ మెమరీ లేఅవుట్ ఫ్రమ్ ద టార్గెట్ డైలాగ్. సో దీస్ టూ థింగ్స్ ఐ నీడ్ టు సెలెక్ట్ అండ్ అప్లై. దెన్ ఆఫ్టర్ దాట్ యూ నీడ్ టు వన్స్ అగైన్ రీబిల్డ్ ద టార్గెట్. సో ఇఫ్ యూ వాంట్ ఫ్రమ్ హియర్ ఆల్సో యూ క్యాన్ డూ. సో ఆర్ అదర్వైజ్ ఫ్రమ్ హియర్ ఆల్సో యూ నీడ్ టు డూ. సో రీబిల్డ్. సో వన్స్ రీబిల్డింగ్ ఈస్ కంప్లీటెడ్ దట్ మీన్స్ క్రియేటెడ్ హెక్స్ ఫైల్. సో క్రియేటింగ్ హెక్స్ ఫైల్. సో వాట్ ఈస్ అవర్ ప్రాజెక్ట్ నేమ్ హియర్? మై ప్రాజెక్ట్ నేమ్ ఈస్ ఎల్ఈడి అండ్ SW8. సో దట్ ఈస్ అవర్ హెక్స్ ఫైల్ నేమ్. డన్. సో హెక్స్ ఫైల్ క్రియేషన్ ఆల్సో కంప్లీటెడ్. నౌ ఐ వాంట్ టు మూవ్ టు సింప్లీ యా. సో దిస్ ఈస్ ద థింగ్ వాట్ యూ హ్యావ్ ప్రీవియస్లీ వి డిడ్ సమ్ ల్యాబ్ విత్ దిస్. సో ఎల్ఈడి అండ్ స్విచ్ ఆల్రెడీ వి డిడ్. సో సేమ్ థింగ్ అండ్ switch. Okay, so this is the arrangement already here. So because I don't want to waste the time, so here I am taking switches. A dip switch arrangement is done here. So that is another set of 8 switches already connected. So according to our pin diagram, same this diagram only 8th pin is connected to so one of the switch. Like that, I connected all the pins. So 8 to so here see 8th pin. This is 8th pin. So I will just, yeah. Now see. So here. Yeah. So 8th pin. This is the 8th pin. 8th pin is connected to first switch. Second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth. So up to 8 switches are connected to 8 different pins. Okay. So according to our program only I selected. And this side, so what I did means simply I selected this thing. So all these are connected to a single point and connected to source. That's it. So that is done. So here I applied certain source. So if you want to, you can give voltage 5 volts, or if you don't want, don't do. So here I am connecting these switches according to our plan. And same way, here I connected 8 LEDs. Okay, 8 different LEDs I am connecting all this. So this, okay. So here also from 16th pin to 23rd pin. So already connected to say over. Okay. So this is already only one new thing is there. That is nothing but a switch you need to select. So this one how to involve into our project means simply dip switch or simply the switch name. Here it is displaying. See. Okay. So yeah. Shell button. So here previously it is button is there. So dip SW. Dip SW. If you type dip SW, so there is a dip switch is there. Dip SW. So here different flavors are there. 10 switches are there and 8 switches are there. 4 are there like that. So what you required? So only I required 8 pin. So that's why I am taking 8 pin. Okay. So 8 independent modules are there in that pin. So this one you need to select. Okay. Dip SW8. That name. Okay. That only new thing here. So remaining all are previous diagram only. So this entire diagram and battery connection, 3.5 volts battery connection. So LEDs and everything is as like previous plan only we did. So now this is the code. So now we need to burn the code into this program. So click on this thing. So browse the thing. So what is our project name? LED and SW8. So that is what you have. So simply you select that thing. So here you need to give 12 MHz crystal oscillator frequency, then press OK. So once done, okay, so this is completed. Now you need to play. Okay, so all are glowing. So if you don't want that thing, any one of the thing, so you select that corresponding switch here. So all, if you put all these are in off on state, so automatically this will all are off state. So if you want to select one thing, you need on. So you need to put like this. Okay, that's why here I am not connecting any push buttons. If I connected push buttons, so this is going to happen. Okay, so if I connected to push button means what? I can't so like this. Okay, so if you connect push button, how I can select at a time two different things? That's why. So I connected dip switch. So this is a good arrangement for your understanding. So done. So our experiment one is done. So like this. So you need to draw this block diagram. So according to pin numbers, you need to port 0, 8 to 15 are switches, and port 0, 16 to 23 are LEDs. Okay, this is your block diagram. So after that, you need to write that code. So I will send that code in your WhatsApp or in Moodle also. So go through the thing, and you need to do simulation to your system, because 78 members are there having laptops with them. So you do simulation. After doing simulation only, you need to send your result. Okay, so in that simulation you need to show your results. That is nothing but simply this type of diagram you show, and you put different arrangements here. So according to that thing only you need to upload your observation. Thank you. This is the first experiment, so completed. That's why I am saving here. So my experiment one is completed. That's why I is changed that thing. So here I am going to give some code. So same code. So here maybe some people are not writing. So these things. Big blue button, it is possible. Paste. Okay, we'll try. Okay, I already pasted the code, source code. So once completed, you tell you completed. So then I will move to next program. Okay. Yeah, I'm talking about simulation as well as this thing, both. Okay. Yeah, once you completed your execution. And if you completed your program, then tell to me. So here one or two persons, yes, yes, like that, you tell. So I will go to next program, that is LCD. Make it fast, write, make it fast. And after writing, yeah. If you have any doubt also, you can ask anyone. You want to see the diagram once again, or if you want to explain once again, such type of things are there, you can ask. So I will explain if you want. But make it fast, make it fast. Don't waste time and concentrate, because these type of labs are help in your future. That is nothing but when you go to Linux drivers, or when you go to embedded system side, or if you are going to learn any high-end language like Python. So nowadays Python is very popular, I think, you know. Yeah. Full stack development is required in Python. Maximum companies are looking like that only. They require full stack implementation. If else statement explain, yeah. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Once again, some people are asking for a basic thing, that is nothing but a previous lab. So in previous lab we discussed about this thing. So what is this thing simply? So here it is not equal to what? Not equal to if not IO pin and S1. So IO pin is 1 previously, suppose you take IO pin is 1. So that IO pin number 0, already it is 0 and 1. So these two, when you are doing the two things, are nothing but AND operation. What happened when you do AND operation on that? So because you are taking the two pins only, so previous state and present state. So automatically, when whether it is 0 or whether it is 1, sometime it is 0, sometime it is 1. So here depends upon S1 value. If S1 is on state, on state in the sense 1. So if S1 is in on state, so because here our reverse operation is performing, because we are performing reverse operation, because we connected that switch to, or that input switch input to 5 volts, because we connected switch as a input, we are not connected switch as output. So you are applying certain voltage on that pin. Okay, when switch is on state, that 5 volts or some VCC is applied to that pin. So that is nothing but high state. So that is equivalent to 1. Digitally it is equivalent to 1. If S1 is 1, that means switch on low unte 1 sir. Switch on low unte 1. Switch off low unte 0. Okay. Whenever switch is in on, so automatically here IO pin. So IO pin 0 in the sense what? So this one, this previous state, I am talking about the previous state. So this both are equivalent to akkada vachina manaku vachina digital input and switch, both are equivalent to 1, automatically what happened? If not, we are talking about not. So not antunnam kabatti, so that is not equal to 0. If 1 aithe 0 ga iskuntade, 0 aithe 1 ga iskuntade. Aa case possible aithe switch on lo unte nemo set cheyi. Evarni on lo unte, switch on lo unte automatically ga em cheyi, ఇది జీరో ఉంది కాబట్టి ఇది ఇది వన్ ఉంటే జీరో అండ్ వన్ అండ్ గేట్ ఆపరేషను పర్ఫామ్ అయింది. సో ఆటోమేటిక్లీ గాట్ జీరో, వన్ వస్తుంది ఇక్కడ, ఇక్కడ వన్ వచ్చింది కాబట్టి ఇక్కడ సెట్ అయిపోయి మనకు జీరోగా చూపిస్తుంది ఇది. ఇఫ్ కండిషన్ ఫెయిల్ అయింది, ఇందులోకి వెళ్ళదు, స్విచ్ ఆన్లో ఉంటే ఇందులోకి వెళ్ళదు. ఓకే, స్విచ్ ఆన్లో ఉంటే ఫస్ట్ స్టేట్మెంట్ ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ అవ్వదు. ఐఓ సెట్ జీరో ఈ 16th పిన్ మీదకి మనం డేటాను పంపించాం వన్ని. ఓకే, సో సెట్ చేయలేము ఈ పిన్ని, అంటే ఫస్ట్ స్టేట్మెంట్ ఇప్పుడు ఫాల్స్ అయింది స్విచ్ ఆన్లో ఉంటే. స్విచ్ ఆఫ్లో ఉందనుకో, అంటే జీరో అయింది, ఇది జీరో, ఇది జీరో అయితే సాల్వ్ కదా ఆటోమేటిక్గా. అండ్ ఆపరేషన్ కాబట్టి మనం చేసేది అండ్ గేట్ లాజిక్ అంటే ఏంటి, ఇది జీరో అయితే ఆటోమేటిక్గా జీరో, సో దెన్ ఇట్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వలెంట్ టు వన్. సో నెక్స్ట్ లొకేషన్ ఇది ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ అవుతుంది. సో స్విచ్ ఆఫ్లో ఉంటేనేమో ఫస్ట్ది, స్విచ్ ఆన్లో ఉంటే నెక్స్ట్ది, అంతే. ఇంకా మిగతా అన్ని కేసులకి సేమ్, ఇదే కాపీ పేస్ట్ చేసాయి 7 times, అంత తప్ప ఏం లేదు. అంటే మనం లాజికల్గా అర్థం చేసుకోవాల్సింది ఏంటి, పిన్ నెంబర్ మీద హై వోల్టేజ్ చేస్తే, పిన్ నెంబర్ 8ని హై వోల్టేజ్గా కన్వర్ట్ చేస్తే దెన్ ఇట్ బికమ్స్ దిస్ స్టేట్మెంట్. హై వోల్టేజ్ ఎప్పుడైతే నువ్వు ఇచ్చావో పిన్ నెంబర్ మీద, సో ఇది వస్తుంది. ఓకే, క్లియర్ అవుతుంది. సో హై నెంబరు అంటే లో ఎప్పుడు ఇచ్చావో పిన్ నెంబర్ దీని మీద, సో ఆటోమేటిక్గా ఇది వస్తుంది, అంతే డిఫరెన్స్. అదే స్విచ్ ఆన్లో ఉంటేనేమో ఎల్ఈడి ఆఫ్ అవుతుంది, స్విచ్ ఆఫ్లో ఉంటే ఎల్ఈడి ఆన్ అవుతుంది. అట్లా రాసాం, నీకు అట్లా వద్దనుకో, స్విచ్ ఆన్లోనే ఉంటే ఆన్ కావాలి సార్ అంటే ఈ రెండింటిని రివర్స్ చేసుకో. సో దీన్ని ఇక్కడ అంటే ఎల్స్లోనేమో ఇది సెట్ చేయి, ఇఫ్లో క్లియర్ చేయి, దట్స్ ఇట్. దిస్ ఈజ్ ఆల్రెడీ వి డిస్కస్డ్ ప్రీవియస్లీ. నెక్స్ట్ అంటే ఈ ల్యాబ్కే చేయలేకపోతున్నావా గ్రీష్మ, లాస్ట్ ల్యాబ్ కూడా చేయలేదా? ఈ మధ్యలో చాలా మనకు 6 days గ్యాప్ వచ్చింది, ఈ మధ్యలో ఎప్పుడు అడగలేదు ఈ క్వశ్చన్ ఉన్నాను, ఇప్పుడు అడుగుతున్నావు. అంటే ఇంతకుముందు లాస్ట్ ప్రోగ్రామ్ ఒక్క అయిందా? అది ఒక్క అయితే ఇది ఒక్క కావడం కాకపోవడానికి రీజన్స్ ఏముండవు. ఇఫ్ ప్రీవియస్ ల్యాబ్ ఈజ్ ఆల్రెడీ డన్, నౌ యూ డోంట్ హ్యావ్ ఎనీ క్వశ్చన్. ఓకే, సో ఇఫ్ యూ నాట్ డన్ ఇన్ దిస్ గ్యాప్, సో యూ గో త్రూ దట్ వీడియోస్, ప్రీవియస్ వీడియోస్ అండ్ యూ డూ ఇట్. ఓకే, సో వాట్ ఎర్రర్స్ యూ గాట్? ఓకే, గ్రీష్మ విల్ షేర్ యు ఆర్ యూజింగ్ ల్యాప్టాప్ ఫర్ యువర్ క్లాస్ ఆర్ నాట్? గ్రీష్మ, ఆర్ యూ యూజింగ్ ల్యాప్టాప్ ఫర్ దిస్ క్లాస్? యూ జాయిన్డ్ త్రూ ల్యాప్టాప్ ఓన్లీ? ఓకే, నో, ఫర్ క్లాస్ ఆల్సో యూ జాయిన్డ్ త్రూ ల్యాప్టాప్? ఓకే, then I will make you as a presenter, so then I will share your screen. Grishma 5055. Okay, yeah, now you are a presenter, just to share your screen. What problem you have? Grishma, click, go to big blue button and you have 3 different options. One is mute, one is nothing but leave audio, one is nothing but share your screen. మేడం వాళ్ళు ఏదో సెలెక్ట్ అయ్యారట కదా యాక్సెన్స్ కి
యు ఆర్ నౌ మ్యూటెడ్
ఏమో సెలెక్ట్ అయ్యారని ఏన అంటాడు మన్న ఏదో అద్దేవే చేస్తాడు ఈయన సెలెక్ట్ దేనికి అయ్యారు ఎట్లా అయ్యారు యాక్సెన్సర్ సెలెక్ట్ అయిన వాళ్ళకి మళ్ళీ ట్రైనింగ్ ఉంటుంది మరి కానీ వాళ్ళు ఏమో ఏమి సెలెక్ట్ కాలేదని వాళ్ళు చెప్తున్నారు సరే సరే మేడం సరే నేను క్లాస్లో ఉన్నాను సరే తర్వాత చూద్దాం ఓకే
ఓకే యు ఆర్ నౌ అన్మ్యూటెడ్
యా గ్రీష్మ షేర్ అవర్ స్క్రీన్ ప్రజెంటర్గా తీసి పడేస్తుంది అంతే వెళ్ళిపోయింది బయటికి ఓకే సో ఎనీహౌ యు గో త్రూ దట్ వీడియోస్ దెర్ ఇస్ నథింగ్ ఇన్ దట్ ప్రోగ్రామ్ జస్ట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎ సింపుల్ సి ప్రోగ్రామ్ అదర్ లైక్ ఎ సింపుల్ సి ప్రోగ్రామ్ సో డన్ రైట్ ఆర్ రైట్ కంప్లీటెడ్ అండ్ ఎనీ వన్ ఆన్సర్ 100 ఓకే డన్ ఓకే నౌ ఐ వాంట్ టు గో త్రూ నెక్స్ట్ ల్యాబ్ ఎక్స్పెరిమెంట్ దట్ ఈస్ వి గివ్ సమ్ స్పేస్ టు దీస్ డయాగ్రామ్స్ అండ్ అవుట్పుట్స్ సో విల్ గో టు నెక్స్ట్ ల్యాబ్ ఎయిమ్ ఎల్సిడి ఇంటర్ఫేసింగ్ ఓకే ఎల్సిడి ఇంటర్ఫేసింగ్ సో యాక్చువల్ ల్యాబ్ నేమ్ ఈస్ సంథింగ్ డిఫరెంట్ సిలబస్ సో so this is the actual statement I'm pasting here so okay write a C program to display message in a two line 16 character LCD display and verify the result in debug terminal okay that is our actual lab yeah that is in message so aim of your project or aim of your lab okay now last year we did 8051 program for LCD maximum people did but some people maybe understand some people not understand I don't know so depends upon that knowledge we will do same but once again I will tell so what do you want to do here so here I am taking LCD so simply I am taking LCD for that purpose only I am using this thing so so I want to discuss about only this thing I don't want to discuss about entire program or entire circuit right now so this is the LCD already you saw in a lot of times this type of circuit I am going to share my screen right now I hope you are able to see my screen. Okay, public chat. Yeah. Are you able to see my screen? Respond, please. Okay. So here, this is a diagram. So because purposely I am showing this thing, but outside how it is there, LCD. So this is the LCD in my hand it is there already so it is visible to you so this is the LCD so module which is available in the market cost is 100 rupees like that so depends upon the quality so we have different costs for this So this is the LCD display. This is alphanumeric LCD display. So in this total two rows are there. Okay, that is nothing but we have two different lines. So each line can accommodate 16 characters. Okay, 16 characters it will accommodate. Okay, this is the LCD what you have. So in camera I am showing right now. Okay, so if you go through back side, so we have certain pins. Okay, so we have certain pins like this. So you can see, yeah. So these pins. So but in every LCD from 1 to 16 pins are there. So I will go through one by one. Okay. So all that pins and everything. So here in our 40s, we are talking always 40s. That's why. So pin number 7 to 14 are nothing but what? D0 to D7. This is nothing but data bus. Okay. LCD have certain data bus. They are nothing but pin number 7 to 14. So pin number 7 to 14 pins are nothing but data bus. And we have three different pins for voltage. So that is nothing but pin number 1 is nothing but VSS. And pin number 2 is VDD. Pin number 3 is VEE. So this is for backlight control purpose. We are going to use these things. And pin number 15 and 16 are used for the purpose of VCC and ground. That's it. Okay, total 16 pins are there. So all these 16 pins, these are used for backlight and contrast. So maintenance, like backlight maintaining purpose. These three pins, 1, 2, 3 are used. And 4, 5, 6 are used for controlling purpose. So data in or out. So for that purpose, you are going to use. So RS and RWE. E is nothing but as like a chip select. Enable. E is nothing but enable. So RS. So RS is nothing but whenever you want to send certain things, that is nothing but if you want to send, sometimes you are going to send data, sometimes you are going to send instructions, that is nothing but commands. So this RS can work in that both cases. Sometimes it is RS is enabled or disabled, depends upon RS value. It selects whether it is an instruction or whether it is a register select. RS is nothing but register select. So it tells that whether it is an instruction or data. So if RS is equal to 1, it is nothing but data. RS is equal to 0 means it is an instruction. So like that. So RW read and write mode and read mode you are talking. So if RW is 0, that means what? Read write bar. So read write bar. So what is read write bar means? So whenever you want to do write bar operation, that means we are writing operation, we are not reading. Yes, from LCD we are going to read. That's why simply I connected to ground. So that is nothing but 0. So read write bar is 0, that means what? Reading. So writing operation only selected. So I write into this LCD. So LCD is in a read mode, but the processor is in a write mode. Only we will write into that thing. So that's why it is in a you can write certain data to LCD. So these are the rows we have. So the first row is called 80 and the second one is called C0. Okay, this one is 80 and this one is the C0. According to this thing, we write our program. So generally we require two control pins, one is RS, one is E. So first we will see if the program depends upon that thing. So we will write our code. So D0 to D7, this is the data bus you need to connect, and these two pins, RS and E, you need to connect to certain pins. Total 10 pins you need to control from your program. Okay, one is RS, one is E, enable, one is RS, and remaining is data bus, D0 to D7. These 7 pins you need to connect. Okay, so according to this one, we will write our program. So go through the thing. So project. So I already did this thing. So LCD project. Okay, this is the project what I have. Stepper. LCD. LCD 1. Address to source group LCD. Okay, this is our code. Simply you have this thing. will see one by one line I will explain. So if you want, you can write with me. So otherwise I will give some time and I will paste this thing into your message. Okay, so this entire thing I will upload into Moodle, no problem. But okay, this is the code already I pasted in your message. Okay, in public message of your big blue button. So now I will go to that thing. Okay, so I will explain the program step by step. First line already you know. So as like previous programming knowledge for initialization of LCD and command write mode, and so LCD commands you need to write, LCD data you need to write. So this is for data. LCD write is for to write the data, and LCD command is for to send certain commands. Okay, LCD commands if you want to send. So what are the commands, sir? There is nothing but cursor move, backlight on, and next character. So in which line I need to work, in which row I need to work. So these are having LCD have different commands. So you download your data sheet if you want. So from Google, if you search LCD commands, so automatically you got LCD commands. So but only required some different commands. So 80 you are going to use, C0 you are going to use. So I will use according to my plan. So I want some only 4 or 5 commands for this. Okay, but we have lot. The LCD commands are more. So here first thing, I am defining 4 different functions here. So this is the first function, void init LCD. So because I need to initialize the LCD, so I don't want to pass any parameters into that thing. So this is for LCD initialization. Next one, the second thing is, I want to LCD write. Okay, so that is nothing but to send data. So this is the function for the to send data. So void LCD command. So if you want to send certain commands to LCD, at that instant you need to use this thing. So here LCD command is nothing but it is an unsigned integer I defined inside. Okay, next to void delay int count. So this is already you know. So to provide certain delay to your program. Okay, now int main void. So unsigned char ch. This is a character array. So in this I stored certain array that is nothing but a certain string called Stanley College. Okay, next one, second thing is one more array I am taking, that is nothing but so CH1. My array name is CH1. So Abbots Hyderabad. So these 2 arrays. So this purposely I am declared something that is IJK. So some variables I declared, unsigned variables. So depends upon my requirement I will. So I want to start this thing. First of all, I want to initialize the LCD. Initialize. Okay. Once initialization done, for I is equal to 0, ch of I is not equal to null. So that is nothing but what? This is the delimiter. So once you got a \0, that means end of the file. Okay. End of your string is nothing but \0. So until end of the string came, so you need to repeat this thing. So what you want to do? First initialize the LCD, and after that send, write this thing. Okay, so LCD write this one by one I need to do. So in LCD initialization only I want to call LCD commands. Okay, so I don't want to, once again repetition is not required for this. So first of all I called LCD, that is initialization of LCD is done. That means LCD is ready, now it is accepting mode. So once that is done, what I want to send, character by character, single character I want to send. So first I is equal to 0, character of I, okay, from that array. So 0th position I want to tell, 0th position in the sense capital S. So this Stanley, okay, in this, so 0th position of that CH array. So is not equal to \0. If it is not equal to, it is not a end of the string, you send, you write into this thing. That's it. One character I wrote on the port. Okay, next. So once again LCD CMD 0xC3. So 0xC3 means what? So I'm setting my cursor at a second line at a third place, 0xC3. For j is equal to 0, CH1 of j is not equal to end of the string. So once again I will send my data. So LCD write CH1 of J. So that means a bit slow A. This is printed in second line. So parallelly I am writing these two. If you want, you can put certain delay also here. Okay, you can put certain delay. So after completion of this thing only I want this thing means. So you need to put some delay. So depends upon that thing, it will repeat number of times. That is done. Now, once it is completed, LCD write CH of J done. Next, while one. So that is already I did. So while one, what is the need of while one here? So means already it is only one time I passed the data into LCD screen. So but I want to repeat that thing, this task. So because I want to run that data, that is nothing but I want to scroll that data from left to right or right to left. So here I want to scroll that data to left direction. Okay, so from left to right direction I want to scroll like this. So if I want like this, data is moving in backward direction, so I am writing this code. So for k is equal to 0, k less than or equal to 16, because my size, that screen size is 16 characters, it will accept each line. So that's why. So k plus plus. So LCD CMD 0x1c, that means so one character every time you need to go with 1 by 1 character like that. Delay, so after every bit movement, so you need to wait some time, some delay also I am putting. So if you don't want delay, speed, that is nothing but data is very very fast, so that much fast is not required for me. That's why I am putting certain delay here. So that's it, that is our code. If you don't want, you can block. Okay, if you don't want these things, so you can block all these things. Okay, so these statements are not required. So if you want a repetition, that is nothing but scrolling, so you can. So if you don't want that thing, so you can just comment it, so automatically this code is not going to affect your code. Okay, now void init LCD. So in initialization part, what I did, so IO direction I am putting 0x0FFFF00. That means what? First 8 bits. So first 8 bits and the last 4 bits. That is nothing but 28, 29, 30, 31. So these 4 bits are nothing but inputs. And 0 to 7th pin. 0 to 7th pin are nothing but inputs. Remaining all are nothing but outputs. So like that I am selecting this thing. So pin number 8 to pin number 27 are nothing but outputs. Okay, remaining all are inputs. Next, that is IO direction I selected. Next, delay. So because initial delay is required for me after setting this thing, that's why I am selecting 100 milliseconds. So LCD command, so 38. So what is the meaning of this 38? And these things are nothing but LCD commands. You go through that command. So once again, I don't want to explain these things. So we have different commands, like around 100 different commands are there for LCD movement, data movement. And if you want to cursor blinking, if you want to backlight on, backlight, construct increment, decrement, okay, bold. So different options are there for these commands. So generally we are going to use these type of commands you can find in any data sheet of your LCD. Okay, now this is nothing but 0C is nothing but a second line, and 08 is nothing but first line. Like that we have different options here. So these are the commands, LCD commands. I am selecting these commands one by one. I want, okay, on LCD and cursor off. So cursor on and backlight on. So like that you have different commands, clear all. So 01 is clear all and set cursor to home. So like that you have different options are there for these commands. So according to that thing you need to plan. Next, void LCD write unsigned into C. Okay, so what is the meaning of this thing? So whenever you are writing something, some character, what happened? So IO pin number, so IO pin, so here IO 0 pin, that is nothing but on port it is already giving an 16th pin. Okay, selected for 16th pin. From 16th pin onwards it is going to select. So what it is going to select? So here we are doing certain masking thing, that is nothing but pin number 16 and 10. So in between the two things only, I selected all my 8 bits. So this my character C is replicated. So that 8 bits are pumped into, or that 8 bits are setted according to my plan. That is nothing but C is nothing but what? One character. One character means what? 8 bits. So these 8 bits are going to activate these pin number 10 to 16 of my port 0. Okay. So whether it is 110 or 011, like that. So depends upon your character, what character you want to send. So depends upon that character, automatically these pins are going to set. Next, delay. So after each character, I want to put some delay. So if you want less delay, you can put this one as a 10 or 50, like that. So milliseconds, I'm talking about milliseconds. Next, so I will LCD command. So whenever command mode is updated, so here also LCD command. So 16 to 10 only, because on that pins only you need to send. Sometimes you are going to send data, sometimes you are going to send this thing. So how that is activated? So because here I wrote pin number 13 is nothing but what? So my pin number 13 is used for enable and disable. Okay. So this enable and disable pin can act as like that. So I want to select that thing, register selection. After completion of register selection, IO pin number 13, and if it is not equal to 0, what happened? If it is equal to 0, what happened? So that means not equal, here I am telling that negation operation. So one time off, after completion of some delay, I will on. So that means what? On and off is done in delay only I will do, because maximum times I call delay. So before every time, so whenever I am setting the IO pin, that's why I easily, for my easiness, I am writing these two statements, before and after delay. Okay, so whenever you call delay, that pin is going to toggle once again. Okay, so that means if it is in a set state, automatically it go to clear state. So once after completion of my delay, it will once again come to back state. So that is the code what you have. So delay is already, you know, to provide certain delay to your program. So this is what is our code. Now we will go to this thing. Okay, first of all you need to make a hex file. Zero errors and one warning is there. So warning, no problem. So options per target and 12 megahertz output. So create X file. Next one, linker. So use memory layout for the target and OK. Then rebuild the target. That's it. Okay, once you did the thing. So hex file is created. What is the hex file name? Okay, LCD init hex file. So this is the actual diagram. Already I did it, so I don't want to waste time. Okay, so pin number E enable is connected on pin number 13, and RS is connected on pin number 10. Okay. So pin number 10, one is connected on pin number 10 RS, and one is connected on pin number 30. So you take a screenshot if you want. Okay, so this is required. Once again I am repeating, RS is connected on pin number 10, enable is connected on pin number 13, and RW is connected to ground. So the bus D0 is connected to pin number 16. D0 is connected to pin number 16, D1 is connected to 17, so on. D7 is connected to 23. Okay, so data 0 to data 7 are connected on 16 to 23 respectively. Done. Remaining circuit is same, that is battery connection and everything, these are same. So only one thing is there here. Nothing but how that LCD. Okay, select on part. So if you type LCD, so you got like this. LCDs are 16. If you type 16 also, you got like that. Okay, it will select. Okay. Okay, so here what is the part name? Okay, because we are going to select LCD. Okay, 16 by 2. So if you select like this also, you got okay display. So this is, yeah, LM1 okay 016 L. So this is a 16 by 2 alphanumeric LCD. 16 by 2 alphanumeric LCD. You need to select. So that is already I did. So this is the thing. LM016 L. So this is alphanumeric LCD. So this circuit, then LCD init CXY. You need to take LCD init. Okay. Open. Change your 12 megahertz. Okay, then play. Okay, one by one letter is coming. Stanley College. Because why I did like this, I want to show more slowly. That's why I put much delay. So if you don't want that much delay, you can reduce the delay. Okay, I will say about Stanley College is came, but it is not visible for us. So now you will see. So that is also scrolling. Okay, one by one, letter by letter, it is scrolling. So it is going to repeat also. Number of times it will repeat because we have Y1. But it works very slowly. If you decrease the delay, automatically yes. Stanley College is in the first row. Okay, second one is Ivy Hyderabad. Yeah. So as a student, what you want to do for this? So you need to do practice how to pass the data from right to left. So if you want to move the data from right to left, whatever. So such type of practice you do. So as a student, you do that practice. So this is already completed. Okay. LCD interface to LPC 2148 is done. So this is second layer. I'm stopping. Any doubts we can ask. Yeah, session is not recorded, but I am recording. I am recording. It is 1 hour record is there with me. I will upload to YouTube. I am recording personally. My computer always recordable. Okay. In big blue button, I am not recording. Thank you, Soumya, thank you. Done. Writing and everything completed. Second experiment. Yeah, this video entire thing I will put in a YouTube. Okay, no problem. Yeah, some people are asking, sir, because I don't have a laptop, how to do this lab like that, they are asking. If people are having laptop also, some people are not doing. If you don't have laptop, how you are going to do? Okay, so no problem. So already situation, you know, I will upload this video to Moodle. That is nothing, Moodle as well as YouTube also. Completed. 59 minutes stop pass. Already 1 hour it is done recording. Next question. Program to implement buzzer interface on IDE environment. Buzzer in the group. Stepper motor interface. Aim to interface a stepper motor. Aim to interface a stepper motor to LPC 2148. Interface a stepper motor to LPC 2148. This is the last lab today. The last experiment. This is the third. Actually, three labs. If you do in your laboratory, we will do only one experiment every week. Yes, but here at a time I completed three. So last week one introduction part. This week I did three different experiments. There three different. I need to do only two next week. One is buzzer. And next one is some serial communication program. That's it. My lab is completed. 5 experiment completed. Okay. So stepper motor interface aim. Aim to interface a stepper motor, unipolar stepper motor to LPC 2148. Okay. Go to keel. I did this program. Stepper motor. Okay, first I will explain the code. So then we will do. So a unipolar stepper motor in the sense it is having four different windings A, B, C, D. Yes. So this already we did in 8086 as well as we did in 8051 also. Stepper motor interfacing is there last year also. Same, but here how to execute that thing, that's it. So but in real time when you are doing, we require certain driver. Stepper motor driver is required. ULN 2800 driver is required. So but here not required any driver because we are simulating in software, that's why. So now first as include stdio.h and as include lpc 2148.h, that thing you need to install. Okay, involve. And after that why delay? So because we require certain delay program, so that's why I wrote why delay void. So int main void. Then pin selection. So first you need to select certain pins. Selection is equal to 00. So select the pin function as GPIO, general purpose input output. I am selecting. So port 0 pins all are as general purpose input output. They can use input and output. And IODIR. So from 0xf, so that means what? Simply I am selecting set the port direction p, okay, pin number okay, set the port direction port 0.42 port 0.7 port pins as output. So that is what I want to select first. So I need to make directly, you can make like this also. So from which pin I want to start? From fourth pin I want to start. So 0xf. So from fourth pin onwards all the pins, that is nothing but next four pins are nothing but outputs. Okay, that is what I selected here. So because to implement this thing I require certain port. On that port four pins are required to send certain voltage levels. So for that I did like this. Okay, so port 0.4, port 0.5, port 0.6, port 0.7 are nothing but what? Our active pins right now. So they are the output pins. Next to simple program while one. So IO clear. So 0xc0. So IO clear 0xc0. IO set. So what is the need of IOX06C0? So this means simply I want to work with this type of data. So what previously what is there, I want to just drop it and I need to send this entire data, that is nothing but 30. So IO set 0x30. What is the meaning of that thing? So 0011. So I want to send 0011. So what is the 0011? So that 0011 can accept according to that pins every time two windings I need to do. Okay, see, first I started with for suppose this is A, B, C, D. If you give some names to these pins, A, B, C, D. So C and D are active right now. So then after that, so that is left shift or right shift, depends upon our requirement. These two windings are on right now. So next to another two windings are on, that is nothing but C and B are going to on. Next time B and A are going to on. Next time, so A and D are going to on. So like that. So that arrangement we need to make. So first of all, we are using two windings at a time, we need to on. So first I on C and D. So next I on C and B. Next I on B and A. Next I on A and D. So that means what? In one direction I completed loop. So once again it is coming to D and A. The D and C. Next to D and C. Next to C and B. Next to B and A. Next to A and D. So that means what? A loop is completing here. So if you want in reverse order, what you want to do? Simply in reverse order only you need to give. So that means suppose 1 and 1, I need to start here only. So next to what I want to do? So D and A I need to do, and after that A and B I need to do, after that B and C I need to on. So like that, if you want to do in reverse order, so you just send that respective ones and zeros to in that. So 1 is nothing but on, 0 is nothing but off, simple. Okay, so this is the data according to that thing only I sent this data. So after completion, I think you are able to see these things. 90 and 90 means what? 1000. So and I was at 6 means 0110. Okay, next to I will clear 30 once again. So previously what is there, you just clear it. So then send this thing. So previously what is there, clear that thing and you send this thing. So like that. Now, so void delay, void int s for s is equal to 0, here I am giving certain delay, simple delay program, that's it. This is very very small program. So but you can do in reverse order also, so that is your choice. So otherwise if you have program 8051 program, that also works, but according to you need to modify, because it is ARM, you need to modify accordingly. Okay, this is the code. Already I sent in group. Okay, now build the thing. So add files to source group, stepper. Okay, LCD is not required for me, remove LCD one. Yeah, errors and warnings, zero errors and warning. Okay, done. Once it is done, my file name is same, sir. LCD init only, because I didn't change the LCD init. So like that also you can work, no problem. My X file name is also LCD init right now, but I wrote stepper motor program in that. Okay, done. So after compilation, that is rebuilding. So you go to this thing and open project. Because already I did, that's why I'm open. Okay. So now can okay. Step bar. Okay. So this is my program. Nothing is there in this except you need to get a motor stepper. So go to pin motor stepper. Motor stepper. Yeah. So motor stepper. Okay, only one thing is there, such type of pin. So motor stepper is there. So that one you need to take. Okay. So for that, already I told four windings are there. So these are the four different windings you have. So each winding is connected to first this A. This is nothing but A. So pin number four is connected to A. Pin number five is connected to B. Pin number six is connected to opposite side, and pin number seven is connected to this thing. So if you think here one winding, second winding, third winding, and fourth winding. So these are the four different windings you have. So according to that thing, you need to select. And it is a 12 volts motor. That's why you need to supply 12 volts AC. So where you need to find? So go to this thing. Here input you need to select. So in this input also, okay, here for suppose you want to select generator. DC generator is required for us. So DC output is required. So that's why you take this DC. So just click here. So if you click on this thing, so it gives, and 12 volts you need to give 12 volts. So like that you need to change this thing. So like that only I gave that voltage. So here I selected the source name is AC, but it is actually DC input I am giving. See, analog types DC. Okay, I am giving DC. If you want to change this thing also, you can. So this is source or power. Okay, so if you can put your name and everything, no problem. So it will accept everything. For your design, you can put any name or any design names like that. So power I applied here, and four pins are connected according to my plan. So now just click on this LCD init HEX. So LCD init open. Okay, everything is okay. Now it's working, but very slow it is doing. See, very slow. So because I gave lot of delay, so to decrease delay, so go to that thing, X file. So here, 5 lakhs is there here. That's why 5 crores. So that's why it is very very problematic to do. Okay, yeah. So that's why I will change it to 1. Save, build the target. So just once again here, I need to LCD init. Okay. Now see, it is working. It is working. Okay. So direction also showing here. So I can do this. Okay. Hope you understood. So this is the app. We have another here. The diagram is nothing but one black box. So this is for it. So in that port 0, we are connecting four. We are in four pins. Port 0 4, port 0 5, port 0 6, port 0 7. So they are connected to motor, ADCD windings. So the common side, two common side, nothing. Side is for easy power supply. Easy power supply positive, easy negative. Like this, you need to these tools. The power is working. Okay. So this is our job, sir. Completed my lab. Three labs completed. So two things are there. We will see that. According to source, yeah. Stepper motor completed, and 8-bit LED completed. So program implement buzzer interface ID environment. So buzzer interface, how much time it will take? So you do. So if it is possible, you do buzzer interface. It is easy. It is very very easy. What is the need of buzzer right now? Okay. So but which buzzer is going to work? So that buzzer system buzzer is going to blow. Actually in our CPU, first of all, if you are using a CPU, inside of that CPU motherboard there is a certain buzzer is there. That buzzer is going to blow. Okay. So if it is not done also no problem. So but you can write this program easily. Only one pin is required. So program to implement a buzzer interface on IDE. So that is very very easy, I think. Okay, if you understand that thing, very easy. So ADC and DAC temperature sensor LM235. Okay, LM35 interface and transmission from kit reception from PC using serial port. So this one I will tell program, but this program I will show in a serial window, and I will transmit the data from memory. Okay, so that will work from kit also. So but now it is not possible because kit is not there with me. That is the main problem. So otherwise I will do this lab, you know, lab. That is nothing but in our college lab. So I entire code I need to put in that kit, and from kit I receive certain data into terminal. So maybe some people aware of that thing. This software, you know, so by using cookie also can do, or by using terminal also can do. Okay, that is the next lab. So in next lab I finish my entire lab. That is nothing but embedded system lab. In EDA, embedded system part I will complete in next lab. Okay, so that is the actual thing. So complete your observation, take screenshots according to your plan, really nothing but after completion of every program. So do entire thing and submit to me. Okay, that is your observation is valid for three things. One is attendance, one is marks, daily evaluation, and one is for next thing. So I will take that attendance and everything, not lab. This lab is nothing. This lab is number three labs. That means 9 classes. This lab is nothing but 9 classes, not one lab. Because so I will give different dates for this lab. So for your record also, I will give different dates. From last month 17th onwards, our lab is going on. So every Tuesday, so I will give that thing. First lab is on I think 18th. So 18th of last month. So after that next lab, after that next lab. So every weekly I will give the dates and everything. So like that only you need to write your record. Okay. So this today's lab is nothing but equivalent to 9 labs. Your attendance, I don't want to take attendance here right now. I don't want to take. So if you are not attended my class, you are not listening this thing also, you are able to submit that thing. So only I will consider that observation. Your observation is nothing but attendance, daily evaluation, and observation. For every lab you need to do that thing. So if you executed, then only I will give marks. If you executed, then only I will give marks. Otherwise I didn't. Okay, execution part also complete. So then only I will give. Thank you. Done. My session is done. Anything doubts or regarding this thing, so I will put this entire thing into YouTube. So tell to your friends.